Welcome students. So in this lecture we will be seeing about the 3D transformation in our computer graphics course. As you might have seen our previous lectures which were based on 2D transformations, where we were doing certain transformations like translation, rotation, scaling, reflection, etc. in our 2D space where we had X and Y axis. Now the same kind of transformations we will see how to do it in a 3D thing. Okay, so let us see how we are going to do these transformations. So let us start. We are having a 3D, we are having three-dimensional space, that is x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So this is the positive x-axis, it is the negative x-axis. This is y, this is negative y, this is z and this is negative z. So again we have to see if there is any point, if there is any point which is recognized as xz, yz and z dash, how we can translate it to another point. So let's say our transformational thing is tx, ty and tz. How you are going to get the new coordinates? So let's say our new coordinates are x double dash. So x double dash is equal to x dash plus the translation of x factor, which is tx. Similarly, the new y is old y, that is y dash, plus what is the translation factor for the y axis, so or y point, that is ty. Another thing is, now we have added one more, which is a z double dash. Z double dash is z dash, which is my old z, plus tz, which is the translation factor of z point. So how we can represent it in a matrix form? So our matrix form would be x double dash, y double dash, z double dash, 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0, and then we have tx, ty, tz, 1 and the old matrix, old coordinate matrix, which is x dash, y dash, z dash and 1. Okay, so what we can call it, this is a new x, this is the new, let's say I am calling it as a capital X. This is a set of new points equal to my matrix M, which is a matrix M for a translation of any 3D coordinate, and then this is the set of old. So X double dash is equal to MX dash. So let's say if you expand it, what is this? This is a multiplication. If you expand it, how it will become? It will again come to the same equation. So this is what my translation. So this is a translation of a, so translation could be of a single point, translation could be of any object. Let's say what will come in my object is of any line, circle, ellipse, etc. So it could be any object, which is my line, which is my circle and which is my ellipse. So how to do for a point, we have seen. So we have an old point which is x dash, y dash and z dash, and its translation points were tx, ty and tz. So how did I obtain my new coordinates? My new coordinates were x dash plus tx, y dash plus ty, z dash plus tz, and it can be represented like this in a matrix form. So Now let's see, how will you do for the line, how will you do for the circle, or how will you do for the eclipse. So let's say I have this line. So this is was just a point. Let's say I have this line which has some start and end coordinates, or two end coordinates we have. Let's say this is x1, y1, z1, and then we have x2, y2 and z2. Okay, now I am considering that I have three more points on this line. So there could be, I am not naming them, just consider I have three more points on this particular line. So you are given a translation point ki, okay, this much should be added in x, this much should be added in y, and this much should be added in z. So what will you do? You will take each point on this line. So how will you do? X1 plus tx, y1 plus ty, z1 plus tz. Similarly, this point you will apply the same formula. On this point, x2 plus tx, y2 plus ty, z2 plus tz. So these are your new endpoints of a line. And do you remember we have solved the line generation algorithm, line scan algorithm, where we had the coordinates of two points and we were drawing the line. So you can take the end coordinates, add them with the translation points, and actually you can get a new line in your translated form. Okay, so we had this line, we had this translation factor, we have added this translation factor in each of the points. They might have gone somewhere. Let's say this come here, this come here, this come here, this come here, and this come here. So this was the end point. So these are the end points. Now you have the end points, you can actually draw a line. So this is how my translation will work in case of the object. So how it is going to work? For each point we have to do the same addition, and we will get the new set of all the points, and there we can draw the particular object. Same in the case of the circle, same in the case of the eclipse. So how we'll do in the circle? So in the circle we have the point for the center, and we have a point for the circumference. So one thing is, you just translate your circle point, center point from here to here, and then you just draw the circle. Or another thing is, you take circle point here, you take each of the point here and make the circle. So it is up to you what kind of algorithm you actually want to use. Same is in the case of eclipse. You can do all those sort of things here itself. So this is our first transformation, which was a translation. Translation is again something where I am just moving my object or my point from one location to another location by giving these three points, which is my translation points, which is tx, ty and tz. So what is my m? Is m currently is 100 tx, 010 ty, 001 tz, 0001. So this is the, if you multiply these two matrices, you will get the new coordinates. This is the multiplicative matrix, and these are my old coordinates. Clear? So we have the translation here.